We want to find all of these zeros or roots of the given polynomial function. To do this, we have two options. We can graph the function and try to find the real rational zeros from the graph, or we can use the rational roots theorem that tells us that the rational zeros would come from the ratio of the factors of the constant term, in this case 15, over the factors of the leading coefficient, which in this case would be 6. But instead of making a long list of possible rational zeros, we're actually going to take a look at the graph of this function to determine our rational zeros. So here's the graph of our function. Since we do have a cubic function, which means it's degree 3, and we have 3 x-intercepts, this tells us that we do have 3 real zeros, but we're going to use the graph to find the real rational zeros. Notice how these first two zeros on the left are real, but they're either fractional or irrational. So let's go ahead and take a look at this third zero of x equals positive 3. We're going to use this zero to help us factor the given function and then find the remaining two zeros. So again, from the graph, we knew that one of the zeros was x equals positive 3. Well, if we have a zero of positive 3, we know one of the factors of the polynomial function must be x minus 3. So let's write this as f of x equals x minus 3 times a degree 2 factor, or a quadratic factor. So to find this factor here, we can perform long division by dividing by x minus 3, or we could perform synthetic division by using the x value of positive 3. Let's go ahead and use synthetic division. So we'll use positive 3, and then we'll list the coefficients of our function. So we have 6, negative 11, negative 26, and 15. Now we'll divide, we'll bring the 6 down, multiply by 3, 6 times 3 is 18, add, multiply, 3 times 7 is 21, add, multiply, negative 15. This sum is 0, which is good. That means the remainder is 0. Verifying algebraically, 3 is a 0 of the function. But this also tells us that this quadratic factor is represented by these coefficients here. Again, we know it has to be a degree 2 factor. So the other factor would be 6x squared plus 7x minus 5. And again, we're trying to find the x values that make this equal to 0. We already have the 3 from this factor. Now we want to find the zeros of this quadratic factor. To do this, we either can use the quadratic formula or try to factor this. And because graphically we saw that the zeros of this will be real, let's see if we can factor it. Again, if it isn't factorable, we'll have to use the quadratic formula. This is a little bit more challenging to factor because of this 6x squared here. We don't know if it's going to be 6x and x or 3x and 2x. Let's try 3x and 2x. And then we'll place the factors of negative 5 in the second positions so that the sum of the inner product and outer product is equal to positive 7. So if we put plus 5 here, we'd have to put minus 1 here. Notice how we have positive 10 here and a negative 3 here, which does give us a sum of positive 7x. So it does factor, and therefore the remaining two zeros must be when 3x plus 5 equals 0. So we'd subtract 5, divide by 3. We have x equals negative 5/3. And also when 2x minus 1 equals 0, add 1 to both sides, divide by 2, we have x equals 1/2. So again, our three zeros are positive 3, negative 5/3, and positive 1/2. Again, all these are real and rational, so notice they all could have been found by looking at the factors of 15 divided by the factors of 6. But there would obviously be a lot of factors to try to find these three. But if we go back and take a look at the graph, we can pretty easily verify this is x equals negative 5/3 or negative 1 2/3. Here's our zero of positive 1/2, and of course our 0 of positive 3. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. We will be looking at several more examples in the next few videos.